And I will just give you one incident to show you what a salah meant for the Prophet يقول ابن عباس رضي الله عنه أرسلني أبي إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. His father sent him to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and he said, "I want you to talk to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم alone. Nobody around the Prophet. So wait until everybody leave, then you talk to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم." So النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم came. ابن عباس came to the masjid right before Maghrib. قال فصلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم المغرب. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was talking to people. The Maghrib prayer came. He prayed sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Ibn Abbas said, "I waited, and when he finished Salat al-Maghrib, I was about to approach the Prophet sallam, لكن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قام فصلى." Ibn Abbas said, "النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم stop praying. Two raka'ah. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم keep praying. قال حتى دخل العشاء. Until Isha came." Ibn Abbas said, "Okay, I'll wait." So النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم صلى صلاة العشاء. قال ابن عباس ثم صلى بعدها أربع ركعات واسترسل. يعني طول. After he finished عشاء, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم prayed four ركعة, but they were very long ركعات. Very long. قال حتى ما بقي في المسجد غيري وغيره. Until nobody left in the masjid, me and him, everybody else left. So ابن عباس رضي الله عنه came to him, and he approached the Prophet to tell him what his father told him to say to the Prophet. Then in Nabi, after he heard, he said, "Would you like to spend the night with me? Today I'm at your khala, at your aunt, Maymuna. Would you like to spend the night with me?" Ibn Abbas said, "Absolutely, what an opportunity." قال يا غلام صلي خلي صلي اقضي معنا الليلة. يقول ابن عباس رضي الله عنه, "We entered and I couldn't find anything in the Prophet's house, any worth of big furniture or anything like that. إلا وسادة جعلها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بعرضها. نام هو وخالتي في طولها ونمت أنا في عرضها." He said, "What I have is one pillow long a little bit. Him and his wife like this on this side, and I prayed and I lay down on this side. Just one room, simple." قال فقلت لا أنام الليلة أرقب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. I'm not gonna sleep. I'm gonna watch what the Prophet I'm doing the night. قلت يا خالة, my aunt, please, if I sleep, wake me up. Okay, don't let me go to sleep. يقول ابن عباس رضي الله عنه وارضاه, we laid down, and not long after that, and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم stood up, and he took some water and he started making wudu and making dhikr. Then in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, and this was around what? About like half of the night. And Ibn Abbas still fighting sleep. Then he said, "I saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam making wudu, making dhikr, and in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam start praying." He said, Ibn Abbas, "I acted like sleeping. I like this. I wake up from the sound of the water. So I acted up as I just woke up, even though I didn't sleep." Then said Nabi Sallam would not know that I was watching him the whole night. Then he said, "I went and I made wudu as well, and I prayed with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam." قال فصلى صلاة طويلة. He prayed long prayer sallallahu alaihi wasallam. حتى كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يرأف بابن عباس. Sometimes Nabi Sallam will feel يعني bad for him, يعني feel pity for him. And he will wipe over Ibn Abbas' head, asfa salat, and sometimes touch his ear. He wakes him up. Until two raka'ah, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he prayed as much as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed him to pray. Then he said he prayed in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, 10 raka'ah, then he made witr with one raka'ah by itself. And in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, after that, he laid down on that pillow. قال حتى نفخ. يعني I heard snoring from him sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Then Bilal came and he told him that Fajr came. Then in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wake up and he prayed two raka'ah. قال فصلى ركعتين خفيفتين. Two short raka'ah. Then he went and he prayed Fajr. Yakhwani, are you following, my sisters and my brother? Are you guys following? From Maghrib until Fajr, And the salah occupied most of the time. At just one night. من قطعت الصلاة في حياتي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. That's how much he is attached to the salah. The question is how much we are attached to the salah. How easy it is for us to push the salah on the side. How easy for us to delay the salah. How easy for us that we join prayers for no really good reason. How fast our salah. When we pray, are we praying just because we want to get rid of it, do the checkpoint, or because we truly enjoy it? Are we looking forward for it? Is really our heart attached to salah?